Hello students, I hope you all are fine. So open your book of social studies. Today we are going to start chapter number 14 and the name of the chapter is communication. In this chapter we will learn about meaning of communication, types of communication. There are two types of communication, personal communication and mass communication. First we will concentrate on meaning and means of personal communication. Under this we will learn about post office, telegraph, telephone, fax and email. Then we will move to meaning and means of mass communication. Under it, we will learn about radio, television, internet, cinema and advertisement. The main objectives of today's video are to learn about the meaning of communication. How did early men communicate? Means of communication. As I have already told you, there are basically two means of communication, but in today's video we will concentrate on the first one, that is personal communication. Under this we will learn about post office and telegraph. The purpose of this video is to give you information about types and means of communication, to enhance your knowledge, to make you familiar with new terminology, to make you familiar with the importance of means of communication in your day-to-day life and advantages of means of communication. So this is the page of your book. Before reading, let's discuss important terms. So the first term is communication. It means exchange of ideas between people. Next is cave painting. It means pictures on the interior of cave. Next is clay tablet. It means soft clay writing material on which signs were inscribed. Next is personal communication. It means exchange of ideas between two persons or people. Next is post office. It is a department to provide various postal services, for example money order. Next is aerogram. It means lightweight letter form which is used to send message to the other countries. Next is telegraph. The method of sending messages through a language of dots and dashes to any part of the world. Now, first of all, let's concentrate on the heading of the chapter. As I have already told you, communication means exchange of information between people. When you are talking to your parents, grandparents, friends, what are you doing? That time you are exchanging your information with them. That is communication. Right now, I am talking to you, I am sharing my information with you. That is communication. It has two types, verbal communication and written communication. Verbal communication is when you are talking to your parents, grandparents, friends through mobile phone, video call, or it may be face-to-face talk. That is verbal communication. Next is written communication is when you are sending messages, ideas, thoughts, etc. through letters, email, text message, etc. This is written form of communication. That's why it's called written communication. Let's start reading. The word communication means exchange of information between people. Exchange of information means sending and receiving information. We communicate through various means like writing or talking. Means are the methods. But how did early men communicate? Nowadays, we can share our ideas, views by writing and talking. But how did early men communicate? The time when they didn't have knowledge of any language, he must have used various sounds and signs in the beginning. The cave paintings at various places in India suggest that
They drew symbols to represent sound for speech.
Student, see a cave painting. Pictures on the interior of cave. Here you can see that pictures were made on the inner side of the cave. These type of pictures, signs, symbols were used by early men to communicate their ideas, their views to others.
Man began to record his thoughts and ideas in clay tablets and palm leaves about 5,000 years ago.
This is a clay tablet. Clay tablet means soft clay writing material on which signs were inscribed, which was later dried in the sun. So these types of clay tablets were used by early man to express his thoughts, views, ideas near about 5,000 years ago.
Take a look to the picture of palm leaf where something is written on it. So these type of palm leaves were also used by early men. It was only with the invention of the printing press by Johannes Gutenberg in 1443 that books began to be printed.
This is a picture of Johannes Gutenberg. He was a man who invented the first printing press in 1443. After his invention, books began to be printed.
Today, printing technology has improved so much that millions of books are being printed in a year.
This is a picture of advanced printing machine. Today, with this advanced technology, we can print number of books, newspapers within few hours. This improved technology made us so capable to print number of books within a year.
Our next point is means of communication. Means of communication means methods of communication by which we communicate with others. In the beginning, messages were sent through pigeons. Later, the postal service was introduced by the British, but it was only with the coming of the telephone that communication was made easier and simpler. Here, the meaning of postal service is post service.
Nowadays, we have so many means of communication, but the first means of communication was pigeon. Earlier, the people used pigeons to send messages to the others. This is called pigeon post.
British people were the first who introduced postal service to the world. The another name of postal service is post office service. At the left side, you can see the picture of Alexander Graham Bell. He was the man who invented telephone. By his invention, our communication was made easier and simpler as compared to pigeon post and postal service. Next point is personal communication. Personal communication means exchange of ideas between two people or persons. We communicate with our friends and relatives by various means. Some of them are, the first is post office. Now, we are going to discuss our first personal means of communication, that is post office. Post office is a department to provide various services, like one of them is money order. Various facilities are provided by the post office. Facilities means services. We can send letters within and outside the country. Postcards, telegram, money order forms and stamps are made available. we can send urgent messages through speed post. Here, postcard is a card that you use to write message to somebody. Aerogram, a lightweight letter form which is used to send message to the other countries. Money order means postal service used to send money. Stamps, a small piece of paper that you stick on a letter. Next is speed post. Speed post means high speed postal service.
See the picture of postcard, aerogram and some pictures of stamps.
All these services are made possible by post office. By these services, we can connect within and even outside of the country. Money can be sent to any part of the country. Now, post offices also offer facilities for saving money. Nowadays, post offices are offering KVP, means Kisan Vikas Patra scheme, by which farmers can save money.
Not only Kisan Vikas Patra scheme, there are so many other schemes which are provided by post offices to save money, and all the people can take benefit of it. Schemes like SSY, Sukanya Smriti Yojana, PPF, Public Provident Fund, NSC, National Savings Certificate, Senior Citizen Savings Scheme. Senior citizen means a person who has attained the age of 60 years or above.
This is Patna Post Office, and all the states have their own post offices. Next point is telegraph. Telegraph means the method of sending message through a language of dots and dashes to any part of the world. Samuel Morse invented the method of sending messages through a language of dots and dashes called Morse code. Messages could be sent to any part of the world through this method, but it is not in use now because of advancement in communication technology.
This is a picture of Samuel Morse, who invented the method of dots and dashes called Morse code. It's an international Morse code. You can see some dots and dashes over here, but it is not in use now because high-speed internet, mobiles, laptops, computers have taken the place of it. I hope all the points that I have explained in this video are clear to you, and now you are capable to give me the answers of the questions that I am going to ask you. First is, what is communication? What are the types of communication? How did early men communicate? What do you mean by cave painting? Define clay tablets. Who invented telephone? What do you mean by personal communication? Name some means of personal communication. Define post office. What is telegraph? Who invented Morse code? Now students, your homework is to solve the exercise that is given at page number 94, revise the chapter that we have discussed today, and revise the terms and note it down in your copy. Thanks for watching. Bye.